ओके सो वी विल सी व्हाट इज रेजोल्यूशन. बेसिकली आई टोल्ड यू रेजोल्यूशन इज बेसिकली फाइंडिंग आउट द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स वेक्टर्स ऑफ दिस गिवन वेक्टर पोज और यू कैन से द रिजल्टेंट वेक्टर. ओके सो और इन अदर वर्ड्स यू कैन से दैट बेसिकली रेजोल्यूशन इज फाइंडिंग द कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ अ गिवन वेक्टर अलॉन्ग अ पर्टिकुलर एक्सिस. ओके दिस एक्सिस कैन बी एनीथिंग, एक्स एक्सिस, वाई एक्सिस or anything, it's up to you. Okay, so here we will consider basically, now you will see that I already told you that, like for example, this vector r was made up of these a and b vectors. So what are the components of r? You will say r, the components of r are a and b. Okay, the component of r are a and b vector. Okay, so okay, now we will find out the rectangular component. Rectangular, there is nothing special in it. It's basically just finding the components along Cartesian plane. Cartesian plane, what I mean the Cartesian plane along x and y axis. Okay, so say this is a vector r here. And this is x axis, this is y axis. And this vector r is making an angle of theta. This vector r is making an angle of theta. So what we have to do, we have to find out the components of this vector. Okay, so how we will find out the component? So to find out the components, first of all, they are along x axis and y axis. So what you will do, you will draw perpendiculars along x and y axis. See, draw perpendicular here and you will draw a perpendicular over here. Sorry, this is the y axis, this is the x axis. Okay, this is the x axis, this is the y axis. You will draw perpendicular on x and y axis. What are we trying to do here? We are trying to find the component of this vector r along x and y axis. Okay, this we are trying to find out. Okay, so let's go ahead. So let us assume this to be point A, this to be B, this to be O, and this to be C. So A, B, C, O. Okay. This is triangle ABO and this is triangle ACO. We will look at these two triangles. So first we will look in triangle ABO. In triangle ABO. So what we have to try and find out here, we will find out the vector that is along this axis. Basically, it is this vector here. Yeah? You have to find out OB, vector OB. What is vector OB? It is the component of R that is along x axis. Okay, how we will find it out? In triangle ABO, you know already the value of R, you know the value of theta, you know two things. Now using trigonometry, you can find out this OB. So OB upon AO is equal to what? Cos theta, yeah? Base upon perpendicular is cos theta. Sorry, base upon hypotenuse is cos theta. So OB is equal to AO cos theta. Okay, what is OB? I will write OB as RX. RX means component of R along X axis. Okay, component of R along X axis is known as RX. I will write here. This is RX here. And here there will be one RY. Okay, so is this clear to you? So what will be Rx? Rx will be equal to R cos theta. Vector R will be equal to R cos theta. Okay, now we will try and find Ry. So in triangle ACO. Okay, in triangle ACO. Triangle ACO. Okay, perpendicular. Sorry, this OC. OC is RY. Yeah, OC upon AO will be equal to OC upon AO will be equal to. This angle is theta. So what will be this angle? 90 minus theta. Okay, this will be equal to cos of 90 minus theta. okay, since this is theta, this will be 30, 90 minus theta. So base upon hypotenuse is equal to cos theta. Okay, and cos 90 minus theta, as you all know, is sin theta. And one more thing here, OC is equal to AO sin theta. What is the value of OC? OC is RY. Equal to AO is R sine theta. Okay, I hope that is clear to you all. So basically vector R has two components along x and y axis. Okay, they are namely RY and RX. Value of RY is R sine theta and value of RX is R cos theta. Okay, now we will find out. We will do one thing here, okay? We will find out the relationship between this RY and RX. We will find out the relationship between three of them, okay? So, what will I do? 1, 2 and 1 and 2, okay? What will I do? I will do square and add 1 and 2. What will I get from here? I will get squaring, we are squaring both the sides of these two and we are adding them. That's what we are doing here, okay? So we will get Rx square plus Ry square, left hand side will be added, is equal to R cos theta whole square plus R sin theta whole square. So Rx square plus RY square is equal to R square cos square theta plus R square sin square theta. Okay, you can all see it here. Now we will write this as RX square plus RY square is equal to R square. Why did I write R square here? Because in the bracket what will come? Cos square theta plus sin square theta. So cos square theta plus sin square theta is what? 1. So it will be R square only. So I can write as R is equal to Rx plus Rx square plus Ry square square root. Okay. Now why I have shown you this relationship? First of all, in some cases they will give you the component. They will give you the component. They will give you Rx, okay, and then they will say find the value of Ry and R. Okay, they will give you Rx, Ry, and you have to find the value of R. How will you find? You will use this equation. If you know Rx and Ry, you can find R, and if you know R, you can find the value of Rx and Ry. It's vice versa. Okay, and also one more thing, there is an important thing. Here, this angle theta, yeah, this was the angle theta we were talking about. This is the angle made by the resultant vector. Okay, so now we will find the trigonometric relationship, the relationship between this. How to find the angle of this? I am say, if you are given Rx and Ry, if you are say you are given Rx and Ry, okay, you are given only these two things, and they ask you to find R and theta. How will you find? Okay, you can find the value of R from this equation, Rx square plus Ry square, under root you can find the value of R, but how will you find the value of theta? Okay, for this we will use another trigonometric relationship. So look in this triangle. In triangle OAB. Okay. In triangle OAB, tan theta will be equal to AB upon OB. Tan theta will be equal to AB upon OB, okay? Perpendicular upon base, nothing complicated in it, okay? Now, what is AB? AB will be equal to, see, this one is RY, this here you all know. Now, this is parallel to this, AB is parallel to this RY. So obviously this and this will be same. So what will be AB? AB will also be RY. Okay. So I can write instead of AB RY. And instead of OB, what can I write here? I can write here RX. Okay. So in other words, tan theta equal to, I will rub this. What will be tan theta equal to? Tan theta will be equal to RY upon RX, or theta equal to tan inverse RY upon RX. Tan theta is equal, theta is equal to tan inverse RY upon RX. So this is the value of theta, okay, and this is the value of R in terms of RX and RY. And this is the value of theta in terms of RY and RX. So if anybody gives you only two things, you need only two things. Like if here in the question you are given RX is equal to 3, RY is equal to 5. Find the value of R and theta. So you can easily find. You know that R is equal to under root of 3 square plus 5 square. Okay, that will be equal to 9 plus 25, so that will be under root 34. So you will find the value of R, and the rest you can also do to find the value of theta. So you will simply do tan inverse. What will be tan inverse? RY upon RX. So 5 upon 3. That you will find, that way you will find the theta also. So this, in this way, this is basically the your resolution of vectors. Okay. In some cases you will see okay, I will rub all of this now. Okay, see, let's see just one small last case. Till now we have seen the 2D Cartesian plane. Okay, now we will see the 3D plane. Let us assume there is a 3D plane. This line here is coming out of the plane. This is the Z axis. This is the Y axis. This is the X axis. Okay, let's assume there is a vector here by the name of R. And it has components along all three axes. Let us say its component here is Rx, sorry, this is Y, this is X. The component here is Ry, the component here is Rx, and the component here is Rz. It has three components along the 3D plane. So the derivation is not important because there is not much scope for this topic in your chapter further. So we will just see the relationship. The relationship is as follows. The R is equal to Rx square plus Ry square plus Rz square. That's it. In case of X and Y axis, it was only Rx plus Ry square. Yeah. But in case of 3D plane, you will add another component, that is Rz square. Okay. That's it. Nothing complicated in it. So, okay. So let us see one question. Yeah, there is a question. Let us see example number 2.5 in your book only. It's given on page number 21. Example number 2.5. So they have given us two vectors. I will read the question first. Given vector A is equal to I cap plus 2 j cap and B is equal to 2 I cap plus j cap. What are the magnitudes of the two vectors? Are these two vectors equal? So this is this is something that they have asked us. Okay, so this is your question, and what they have asked is, are these two vectors equal or not? Okay, so what do they mean by these two vectors are equal? Okay, so first of all, to ensure that the two vectors are equal or not. Okay, there are two important things that you have to find out. Basically, their magnitude should be same, okay, and their direction should be same. Okay, so you can see here, the first of all, we look at this vector. So this vector, the resultant we will find out of this vector, first vector A. So you can see here, it is I cap plus 2j cap. What does this I and j cap? I already told you, I and j means unit vector along x and y axis. I represent x and j represent y axis. Okay, and when you put cap, it means unit vector. Okay, so what does this indicate? This indicates that along the Cartesian plane, okay, there are two vectors we will make. This is the x axis and this is the y axis. There is one vector of one unit and another vector of 2 units here. So now you can see here, the two vectors are already given to you. In other words, what is given to you? You have already given the value of rx and ry. You can see here, yes, rx is equal to 1 unit and ry is equal to 2 units. Okay, now we have to find out the value of the resultant. So now we saw the formula earlier, how to find this value of r. We saw earlier, yes, r is equal to under root of what? Rx square प्लस आर वाई स्क्वायर. अभी थोड़ी देर पहले हमने देखा था ये फॉर्मूला. तो अब क्या होएगा इसके अंदर, आर एक्स स्क्वायर की जगह क्या आएगा, 1 का स्क्वायर प्लस आर वाई स्क्वायर की जगह क्या आएगा, 2 का स्क्वायर. सो व्हाट विल इट कम आउट टू बी, 1 प्लस 4 इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ऑफ 5. आई होप दैट इज क्लियर टू यू ऑल. ओके, अंडर रूट 5. व्हाट इज द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ए, इज अंडर रूट 5. अंडर रूट 5. Okay, the second thing, b is equal to 2i cap plus j cap. Now what does this mean? Let us see. See, this is the y axis and this is the x axis. Okay, so along the x axis, what is the value of the vector? 2 units, because 2i cap, I cap is x axis. Yeah, and how much is the value here? 2 units. And what is the value along y axis? That is 1 unit. Okay, now here the value of rx is 2 units, ry is equal to 1 unit. So now you can find the resultant again with the same formula, this one. Yeah, so what will it come out to be? Rx square 2 square plus ry square 1 square is equal to 4 plus 1 under root is equal to under root 5. Okay, that is clear to you. Now you can see b magnitude is also 5. Now the second thing that comes is, that is the very important thing. Now most of the children, they will see that root 5 is equal to root 5. End of question. Because the magnitude is same, they will think that it is equal. It is not equal yet, because vector is defined by two quantities. First one is magnitude, second one is direction. So we already found the magnitude as root 5, and that is same. Now the second thing we have to find is the direction. Now we will find the direction of these resultant vectors. Okay, so what was the formula of the direction of resultant vector? Tan theta is equal to rx ry upon rx. We found out already, yeah. So tan theta for this one, theta is equal to tan inverse ry upon rx. So let us find the value of ry and rx. What is the value of ry and rx? Rx, theta is equal to tan inverse, what is the value of ry? 2 for case a and 1. So it will be tan inverse 2. So tan inverse 2, this is the value of this. Okay, and what is the value of this b, resultant of b? Theta is equal to tan inverse 1/2. So these two angles, I am not sure, but this angle will come approximately, I don't have the calculator right now, but it shall come around 70 degrees. Let's assume it will come out to be 70 degrees. And this angle, this will be around, let's assume it to be 30 degrees. So as you can see, the angles are different, okay? The angles made by the resultant of these two vectors are different, but the magnitude is same. So are these two vectors equal? No, they are not equal, because the direction of these two vectors is not the same. So this is how you will proceed in these type of questions. Okay, now we will see the product of vectors, the basically multiplication of vectors. This is a very important topic, so I will drop all of this. Okay. So now we will see the product of, okay, one thing you already know, I told you in the beginning, product of vector into scalar, that is always a vector. Okay, always. There is nothing complicated in it. Okay, this we have seen already. So that there is nothing to remember. It's always vector. Vector into scalar is always vector. Never forget that. Okay. Now the complicated thing that comes is vector into vector. Okay. What is vector into vector? Okay. So vector into vector, it can be two possibilities. The possibilities are, the answer can be scalar, and the second possibility is the answer can be vector. Okay, there are two possibilities. Okay, this, in this case we call it as dot product. When multi, when vector into vector the answer comes to be scalar, we call it a dot product, or you can say it as, some, in some books you will find it as scalar product, scalar or dot product. That's the same thing, there is no difference. Okay, scalar or dot product. Okay, and another one, this one is known as cross product. Or you can say this as vector product. So these are the two types of products that are commonly used. 99% cases that the formulas that you have studied till now, like work done, yeah, you know work done, then you know the formula for force, mass into acceleration, then there is a formula for momentum, yeah, all these formulas, they are classified into vector product or scalar product and respective. Okay, we will now see different types of, first we will start with scalar product, then we will see. Okay, the simple example of scalar product you can see is that work done. Work done, you must already all know, is force into displacement. So it is basically force into displacement. It is basically written as F dot S. Okay, what does it mean? Fs cos theta. We will see in detail what is that. Work done is an example of, what I am trying to say is that the work done is an example of a dot product. Okay, we will see it in detail. Vector into scalar, there is nothing complicated here. Yeah? It's simple. So first one is the scalar product. Okay, I will first read the definition and then we will see it accordingly. According to the book, it's written that scalar or dot product of two non-zero vectors P and Q is defined as the product of magnitude of the two vectors and the cosine of angle between the two vectors. Okay, so what does this say basically? If there are two vectors, P and Q. Okay, so how this indicates what product? This indicates the scale. Dot means scalar product. When you see dot, That means we are talking about scalar product. So how you will find the scalar product? It is quite simple. You will multiply these two vectors, okay, and multiply the magnitude of these two vectors and multiply it with the cos of the angle between these two vectors. Okay, say this is vector P, this is vector Q. So this theta is the angle between these two vectors. So basically this is your which product? This is the scalar product. Okay, scalar product is basically the magnitude of these two vectors, okay, into the cos of angle between the these two vectors. You multiply these three, you will find the scalar product. Okay, so what is the basically the characteristics of the scalar product? What are the scalar product characteristics? We will see. The first characteristics is what the scalar definition of exact definition of the scalar product is. It is basically the product equivalent to the product of magnitude of one vector with the magnitude of the component of the other vector in the direction of the first. Okay, so what does this mean? Okay, let us say this is the vector P here. How did this PQ sin theta came? We will see that in detail. Okay, and this is vector Q here. Okay, so what does the basically definition say? It is basically the product of first vector, according to the book it is written, product of first vector with the second vector, with the component of the second vector in the direction of first. इसका मतलब क्या है? इसका मतलब ये है कि इसका जो है हमने क्या निकालना है, कॉम्पोनेंट इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ फर्स्ट वेक्टर. ओके, सो इन केस वी आर फाइंडिंग पी क्यू, वी आर फाइंडिंग पी डॉट क्यू, तो हम कैसे निकालेंगे? हम क्या करेंगे, पी को मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे किसके साथ? क्यू का जो कॉम्पोनेंट है पी की डायरेक्शन में, वो कॉम्पोनेंट हम कैसे निकालेंगे बताओ? ये थीटा एंगल है. I already told you earlier resolution of vectors. हाँ, तो हम क्या करेंगे? What we will do? We will drop a perpendicular here. We will drop a perpendicular here. Okay. Now you just imagine it. What I am trying to do here. Okay. I am making this straight for you. Say this is Q here. This is same. This is just the. मैंने इसको बस थोड़ा घुमा के for your reference सीधा कर दिया diagram को. ओके, तो यहाँ पे क्या आएगा? अगर ये थीटा एंगल है तो इसका कंपोनेंट क्या होएगा? इधर क्यू कॉस थीटा, ये भी हमने थोड़ी देर पहले देखा था, वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन दिस अर्लियर. ठीक है, तो इसको मैंने बस ऐसे सीधा किया है आपकी रेफरेंस के लिए. नाउ यू लुक हियर, यहाँ पे क्या आ जाएगा कॉम्पोनेंट? क्यू क्या आ जाएगा? कॉस थीटा. और फिर आप इन दोनों को मल्टीप्लाई कर दोगे तो क्या मिल जाएगा इनका वेक्टर प्रोडक्ट? पी क्यू कॉस थीटा. Or you can write as P dot Q. ठीक है, same you can do from this. अगर आपसे पूछा, if you are asked Q dot P, if you have been asked Q dot P, then what will you do? You will multiply Q with the component of P in the direction of Q. तो कैसे करोगे इसे? यहाँ पे perpendicular drop किया और P का component निकाल लिया, तो वो क्या आएगा? P cos theta. ओके, और इन दोनों को मल्टीप्लाई करोगे तो क्या मिल जाएगा आपको? Q इंटू पी कॉस थीटा. तो आंसर इसमें भी सेम आएगा, क्यू पी कॉस थीटा. ओके, तो इससे एक बात पता लगती है हमें कि इन आपका जो आपका इन वेक्टर प्रोडक्ट जो है, वेक्टर प्रोडक्ट ऑबेज द कम्युनिकेटिव लॉ. कम्युनिकेटिव लॉ मल्टीप्लीकेशन क्या होता है? 2 into 3 is equal to 3 into 2. पता है ना आप सबको, it is the same thing 6. वैसे ही P dot Q is equal to Q dot P. The answer will be always same. इसमें भी आएगा PQ cos theta और इधर आएगा QP cos theta. Answer will be always the same. It is the same thing when you multiply all these three things. Okay. So this was the basics of your vector product. Okay. अच्छा, अब हम इसका एक इम्पोर्टेंट चीज देख लेते हैं. स्पेशल केसेस है थोड़े. इन केस ऑफ वी विल डू अ एग्जांपल. ओके, see it from an example. Let us assume there is A is equal to 2 cap plus these two are the vectors. So what we have to find, the dot product of A and B. Okay, so we will try and find the dot product of A and B. Okay, so you can see that A has component of 2 units along i cap along x axis and a component of 3 units along y axis, whereas B has a component of 1 unit along x axis and 2 unit along y axis. So we'll find out A dot B. So now we will open the brackets, okay? So this one you can write as 2i cap dot i cap plus 2i cap dot 2j cap plus 3j cap dot i cap plus 3j cap dot 2j cap. Okay? Now you all already know, okay? I dot I क्या होएगा? 2 I dot into 2 क्या होगा? ये क्या होएगा? मैंने बताया था ना, A dot B क्या होता है? A B cos theta होता है? थोड़ी देर पहले बताया था मैंने, हाँ? तो ये हो जाएगा 2 I into I cos theta, है ना? Cos theta क्या था? What was theta? Theta was the angle between the two vectors A and B. अब यहाँ पे दोनों वेक्टर सेम डायरेक्शन में है. देखो, एक वेक्टर 2 यूनिट्स का है x एक्सिस का लॉन्ग और एक वेक्टर है 1 यूनिट का. देख सकते हो ना, 2i into 1i, एक वेक्टर की वैल्यू क्या है, 2 यूनिट्स और एक की कितनी है 1 यूनिट. दोनों का बीच में एंगल कितना हुआ अगर दोनों सेम डायरेक्शन में है? इट विल बी 0 डिग्रीज. तो यहां पे क्या आ जाएगा? 0. तो cos 0 क्या होता है? 1 होता है. ओके, तो व्हाट वी कैन राइट इनस्टेड ऑफ हियर, 2 और i कैप की वैल्यू क्या होती है? 1 यूनिट. तो i, ये इससे हम एक रिजल्ट निकालते हैं हमेशा के लिए याद रखना. i डॉट i क्या होता है? ऑलवेज 1 क्यों होएगा? बिकॉज़ cos 0 क्या होता है? cos 0 क्या होता है? 1 होता है, ठीक है? और i और i तो वैसे ही यूनिट वेक्टर है, तो 1 into 1 into 1 क्या होगा? 1 होएगा. तो i cap into i cap क्या होएगा? 1. ओके, नेक्स्ट केस देखते हैं. यहाँ पे नेक्स्ट केस क्या है मेरा? 2 i cap into 2 j cap. तो ये क्या होएगा? 2 i cap into 2 j cap into cos of theta. अब देखो, एक वेक्टर है 2 एक वेक्टर है मेरा 2 यूनिट्स का, किस डायरेक्शन में? x एक्सिस की डायरेक्शन में, बिकॉज i cap मतलब x एक्सिस. और एक वेक्टर है y डायरेक्शन में, कितनी वैल्यू है उसकी? 2 यूनिट्स. j cap है ना, तो वो भी y एक्सिस में है, ठीक है? तो इन दोनों के बीच में एंगल कितना है? 90 डिग्री है ना, है ना? तो यहाँ पे cos थीटा में थीटा की वैल्यू क्या आएगी? 90 डिग्री. और cos 90 क्या होता है? यू ऑल नो इट इज 0. तो जब भी मेरा i into j होता है, i dot j हमेशा क्या होएगा? 0. क्यों होएगा 0? बिकॉज इनके बीच में एंगल क्या है? 90. cos 90 क्या होता है? 0 होता है. तो ये पूरा का पूरा टर्म मेरा क्या बन गया? 0 बन गया, ठीक है? वैसे ही मेरा ये वाला टर्म देखो, 3j cap into i cap. ओके, तो 3j cap मतलब यहाँ पे वेक्टर की वैल्यू क्या है? 3j cap into i cap, यहाँ पे i cap है. तो इन दोनों के बीच में भी एंगल कितना है? 90. ये भी पूरा का पूरा क्या हो जाएगा? 0. क्यों? बिकॉज cos 90 आएगा. इसको मैं क्या लिख सकता हूं? 3j into i into cos of 90. तो ये भी 0 हो गया, ठीक है? बचा आखिरी वाला 3 into 2 j cap into j cap. तो मतलब एक 3 यूनिट्स का इधर है, नहीं, एक 3 यूनिट्स का इधर वेक्टर है और एक और वेक्टर है 2 यूनिट्स का, जो 2j cap है, ठीक है? दोनों सेम डायरेक्शन में, तो एंगल कितना है दोनों के बीच में? 0 डिग्रीज. तो इसकी वैल्यू क्या हो जाएगी? 6 into कॉस ऑफ जीरो क्या होता है, वन होता है, यहाँ पे सीधा वन आ जाएगा। तो ये आंसर क्या हुआ, 6 + 2 = 8। ठीक है, तो इस जो हमने केस देखा है इससे हमारे पास एक दो तीन फॉर्मूले आते हैं जो मैं यहाँ पे लिख रहा हूँ आपके लिए, बड़े इंपॉर्टेंट है वो वेक्टर इसमें डॉट प्रोडक्ट के केस में। वो फॉर्मूले हैं आई कैप डॉट आई कैप इज इक्वल टू जे कैप इज इक्वल टू के कैप डॉट के कैप इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू वन। ऐसा क्यों है, आई कैप डॉट आई कैप मतलब एक्स एक्सिस के लॉन्ग दो वेक्टर है, दोनों में एंगल क्या है, जीरो डिग्री। कॉस जीरो क्या होता है, वन होता है। जे मतलब वाई एक्सिस दो वेक्टर दोनों में एंगल क्या है, जीरो डिग्री। और के मतलब क्या है, जेड एक्सिस मतलब यहाँ से बाहर आ रही है एक्सिस, और दो वेक्टर सेम डायरेक्शन में है, ओके दोनों के बीच में एंगल क्या होगा, जीरो डिग्री। तो इन केसेस में हमेशा क्या होगा, डॉट प्रोडक्ट वन होगा। बट इसके अलावा जो भी केस है, आई डॉट जे, जे डॉट के, के डॉट आई, जो भी आपके माइंड में आता है जितना भी आता है वो सब क्या होएगा, जीरो होएगा। या फिर जे डॉट आई, के डॉट जे, आई डॉट के, हर केस में जीरो आएगा। ओके, इट विल बी ऑलवेज जीरो, बिकॉज व्हाई, बिकॉज ऑल दीज आर परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर एक्सिस। एग्जांपल ले लो कोई भी, आई डॉट के, आई डॉट के मतलब आई एक्सिस यहाँ पे है, मतलब एक्स एक्सिस में एक यूनिट वेक्टर है वन यूनिट का, डॉट के मतलब आई डॉट के मतलब क्या होएगा, आई के कॉस थीटा, और के मतलब एक बाहर की तरह वेक्टर आएगा, मतलब टेबल इससे ब्लैक बोर्ड से बाहर आएगा, उसका एंगल कितना है, 90 डिग्री, वन यूनिट का है वो भी। तो क्या होएगा, कॉस कॉस 90 क्या होता है, जीरो होता है। तो इन हर केस में आप ट्राई कर लेना, अपने कॉपी में करना पेन पेंसिल से, हमेशा आंसर जीरो आएगा। ठीक है, तो ये आपका क्या हो गया, डॉट प्रोडक्ट। ओके, सो डॉट प्रोडक्ट की एक सिंपल सी एग्जांपल देखते हैं। सर एक सेकंड,